think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a second drive, no first down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play call is starting to happen, right? You see it, now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going.
A breakaway for Michael Thomas. And he is into the end zone. They snap it to Stafford. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Gordon. 18 thing going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Here's Abdullah. And inside the 20 before he's brought.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why I lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme. Get a little bit. Tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
He goes underneath to Ingram. Study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it. Six. And he's got his man, that's Snead. Touchdown, New Orleans. Off the bootleg, Stafford. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And the return.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, it'd be in right. This is going to be third and 13. To throw is Stafford. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker.
You got a back who's quick and shifty. He can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people. And then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from the first. Then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
And the Saints pressure gets him.
Skates this entire game. The way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
Sliding out of the pocket. Caught on the right side by Jones. Now a play fake here on first down. Flush to his right. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll get there.
And was still accurate throwing the football.
Stafford. That is caught at the 7. And eventually. Throwing again at Stafford. And he's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. 5-4, not huge, but still the big thing, winning on the road to stay alive. Pretty big deal.
Man, when you pointed out that 5-4, first thing that flashed in my head was college ball.
Adrian Peterson off to the races. Touchdown, New Orleans. Adrian Peterson. They go play action here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. On second down, here's Stafford. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes.
In this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offense.
And the pressure gets to him again. Jason Jones.
It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Desperation time for Stafford on fourth down. He's going to loft. He's got a man. Complete. Jim Caldwell's guys cannot come through there on fourth down. Charles on the losing side of things. You know, they didn't come in here as the favorite to these playoffs, but they came in with a lot of hope and anticipation. Tough to have that all snuffed out so quickly.
It really is. You're one of 12 teams when the playoffs begin that still has a chance to win the Super Bowl. So that's pretty darn good. And as you often talk about, a lot of hope when the playoffs start. Well,